Hagerty trial, yesterday the jurors asked Judge Zobel who is the actual victim in the Hagerty trial. Well, today the jurors showed that they are Mike Bloomberg's friend. They are the billionaire mayor's, multi-billionaire mayor's friend, and they're going to send Hagerty to jail. It's laughable for money laundering. Mike Bloomberg is the king of money laundering, of funneling money. Let's ask about his Cayman Island money. The stories go on and on, and nobody really wants to report them. And no one wants to report that Mike Bloomberg committed perjury. He has immunity. No one wants to report that Cy Vance, the DA, tried to prevent Hagerty from even defending himself. Then when they couldn't do that, they gave everybody, and it's a really long list of people that the DA called that worked for Mike that all had immunity. Why did they need immunity if they're innocent? Why didn't they waive immunity if they're innocent? Because they're guilty. But for some reason, it's been decided John Hagerty's going to go to jail. Are you kidding me? I know that he's going to appeal this. That's a no-brainer. But I'm just stunned that the jury could go from 24 hours from who's the victim here, and the real victim are the people of New York City, to finding Hagerty guilty, when in fact Mike Bloomberg funneled a record amount of money to people. There was sub-zero trickle-down. No one's asked for a full forensic audit of this past election and the election before when he funneled money to Hagerty. And he lied and said he didn't know Hagerty well. He attended Hagerty's father's funeral, and I believe he did robocalls for Hagerty's brother. Come to our protest. It is Sunday, 2 p.m. If it's under 20 people, you can find us in the park at City Hall. The protest is the term limits anniversary. October 23rd is a 3-year term limits anniversary. And if there's more than 20 people, if Occupy Wall Street joins us, then we'll be on the east side of City Hall by the subways. So come, it'll be a short, peaceful protest against Mike Bloomberg and Christine Quinn, term limits. That, again, it was part of the whole deal that Mike Bloomberg and Christine Quinn made a backroom deal to prevent us from having a vote on term limits and pushing it through a corrupt city council. They used slush money. They abused taxpayer money called slush money to push through an illegal third term. We will be there protesting. Quinn said we needed Mike Bloomberg to help us with the economy. Did Mike Bloomberg and Christine Quinn help you with the economy? No, but they grew richer. Explain to me how someone we pay a dollar a year keeps earning billions of dollars. Mike Bloomberg, king of New York, corrupt mayor, and everyone there was guilty and had immunity except for Hagerty, who he's been funneling money for. Explain why they made up their mind to target Hagerty when Mike Bloomberg is the one who's guilty. And as far as I'm concerned, Christine Quinn, guilty. Guilty of abusing slush, preventing us from having a vote on term limits and pushing through an illegal third term. They used Mike's charity. He created a dummy company that he was paying Alison Jaffin and two other people salaries from that wasn't Bloomberg News. You name it, they did it. There's the hedge funds, Quadrangle, then it was Willett's advisory that Fiona Reed, Miss Moneybags, Hagerty's mistress, worked for them and yet was handling the money for the campaign. And it's so obscene. More corruption in your face. It's like the NYPD rape cop heroin hidden in the rape cop's locker that Cy Vance decided we'll just roll that into a year. Are you kidding me? African American and Hispanic New Yorker said if they had heroin on them, they'd be going to jail for 80 years. You don't roll that into a year. Dirty DA. Vote Christine Quinn out of office. Vote Cy Vance out of office.